capital. If you want to make a million, don't try to make a million. Get $1 from a million people. You know how doable that is? Homeless people do it all the time. Homeless people do it all the time. Just think about it. I was watching a study. The average homeless person makes $271 a day. A day. Tax-free. Which means what? They get a dollar from at least 271 people. Theoretically, granted, sometimes it's change, sometimes it's big money, whatever. At least $1 from 271 people. A day. But whatever though, you feel me? That's where we really need to go with this show. But it starts with self, yo. We need to first get the control right, you know what I'm saying? So that way we can get out of this sympathetic mode. Like, we gotta get out of survival. We gotta get out of survival mode. They keep us here. For those of us that have actually gotten out of survival mode, we left the hood, we went to school, whatever, we think we made it. Nigga, we made it. You feel me? How do they keep us in survival mode? We work 9 to 5, they give us promotions, then we get more hours, we lose time, and you feel me? It is what it is. Keep them distracted. You keep everybody distracted from getting out of sympathetic mode. And then if you can't get out of sympathetic mode, no, you don't help anybody else get out of sympathetic mode. But even still, we stay in sympathetic mode even when we go off that far. Motherfuckers be in debt to their eyebrows just to have a degree. But then you gotta go back, you gotta keep going back to school. Cause and all of that money that you spent and all the time you went, you can never get any experience. So you can't work. You need at least 3 years. When was I gonna have time to get 3 years of experience in a 4-year degree that I, that shit's, you see? That keeps you in sympathetic mode, fight or flight response. How am I gonna pay this shit back? But it is what it is. The moment we come out of that shit, life changes. I'm telling you. I'm telling you. We need to be the generation, my generation, whoever doesn't have children right now, who hasn't created the next generation yet, make sure you learn how to get out of sympathetic mode and learn how to be so stable that when your kids come into this world, that they're not a burden. They're not a bill. They're not extra. You feel what I'm saying? If you can barely make ends meet for yourself, why are you having kids? I don't get it. Is that the impetus to make you work harder? Again, do you see how important it is to control yourself? If I had control over myself and I put all my power within me and I use me to control myself, I wouldn't need to create a child to say, now I'm gonna work harder. I would've already been in that position because I'm like, yo, when I bring children into this world, they ain't gotta worry about nothing but being a fucking child. But you know, it is what it is, you know? We live, we learn, and we move forward. But what more can we do, you know? Other than live life. But we gotta get out of survival mode. We gotta obtain the knowledge to keep motherfuckers from being able to impose their will upon us. We gotta be able to personally control ourselves, be accountable and responsible for our actions. Until we do that shit, we always gonna be at the mercy of other people. We're never gonna be able to buy the communities. We're always gonna have boarded up abandoned houses that get gentrified and redesigned later. Buy the block. Buy the block, you feel me? Take pride in it. See, again, the hood is in the mind. It's not the place you live. The place is the physical manifestation of what's going on in here, collectively with all the people. We don't have time to keep the neighborhoods clean. We don't have time to keep shit from being banded up. We don't give a fuck about that. We worried about this next bag I'ma get. That I'ma blow somewhere else. Just a stunt. You feel me? Shit's gotta change, yo. Shit's gotta change. And we gotta stop. I'ma keep it a bean with you. The revolution is gonna start and end in the hood. You can motherfucking get to that point where you want some, yo, we're gonna be the talented 10th, or we're gonna be this. Think you're gonna be that shit you want to. You ain't gonna do shit without the hood. So, have some modesty. and seek to relate to this person. We all the motherfuckers in the hood ain't gonna rob you. All the motherfuckers in the hood ain't deceptive. You gotta think about their circumstances. I'm not saying going to the motherfucker and just chain you. You gotta meet with an OG to get into the motherfucker. You gotta meet with the OGs that have already put in the work that are no longer, you know what I'm saying? But you gotta make sure it's an OG, not just an old little nigga. It's too many of them now. You feel me? You should be able to structure and start to channel that shit and change it. You feel me? This shit is difficult, but it's not impossible. You feel me? Just because we got degrees and shit, we don't need to go into this motherfucker, oh, I'm going to change. Nah. You got to still be able to relate, be able to use the jargon. We step into academia, we step into corporate America, and we put on this whole suit. Why can't we step back into the hood? Think about that shit. We would comfortably put the mask on to go into academia, but we won't put the mask on to go here. Why? Because we're afraid. It's fear. So who are we really thinking like? If they fear the hood and we fear the hood and we assimilated to them and we comfortable with them as we more comfortable than we are with the hood, that's a problem because this is where our people are. You feel me? We need to bring them out. But you can't bring them out unless you go in. But in order to get in, you need to pass. But you, to get the pass, you need to relate. You feel what I'm saying? You think motherfuckers want to stay in the hood? Yeah, rap music and all that other bullshit has glorified. Yeah, shooting, killing, bang, bang. Yeah, yeah. That's just not fun. That's just not cool looking over your shoulder, wearing it, having to have the psychology of the, having the need to have a chopper. Ain't nothing good about that. Knowing that motherfuckers might try to kill you, that's not cool. But I'm strapped though. We strapped for survival. You feel me? But now we need to start teaching now, be legally strapped. Don't go to jail. Do this, do that, create a job. Create, like, we gotta start giving back because they can't, like, why can't we get high? Like, there's certain shit you can't do. You feel me? Certain shit you can and can't do that, or you should and shouldn't do. That's like, okay, cool, it's time to progress. We're not in survival mode no more. You feel me? We run the culture. We shape the world. Look at hip hop. Hip hop is the hood, but hip hop runs the world. So I say the challenge is this. Get back into the hood. You feel me? If you left, go back. You feel me? I'm not saying you have to go back to your particular hood. You feel me? Some of us, we might not be welcome back in the hoods that we go from. I'm not speaking on myself, but I'm just saying. Some of us may not be able to go back to where we went because of the way we left. You feel me? So we don't need to continue to do that. If you leave, you need to say, look, this is the way out, but it's going to require you to do X, Y, and Z. They don't have to, like, we can't change who we are, but you can't enhance it. We're no longer descendants. We are now ascendants. We need to be going up. We don't need to be staying the same plateau. It's enough bad bitches and hood niggas. It's enough bad bitches and real niggas. You feel me? I get the impetus that we're trying to, well, we can't make that a term of endearment. We didn't create it. We didn't create the original thought process behind it. A nigga has never been good. A bitch has never been good. But whatever. We need to shape that narrative and we need to change it. I'm not saying, you know what I'm saying, denounce who you are, none of that shit. If you're from there, you're from there. But understand now that it's time to get the people that are from there that can move and maneuver better. You feel what I'm saying? Some people you particularly can't reach, but you can reach somebody that can reach somebody else. You feel what I'm saying?